Good morning from Lanzhou West Railway Station. Today I was taking a high-speed train from here to Beijing. I arrived here yesterday by a D train, which is also categorized as a high-speed train from here Urumqi to here. I will be doing it first class today. I hope you enjoy the video.
With a population of, well, a little more than over 3 million people, Lanzhou is not a big city for China standards. This city has several railway stations, so check your ticket before you go to the station. Most high-speed trains do depart from Lanzhou Qi, or Lanzhou West as it's called in English. I also arrived here yesterday by a D train from Urumqi. You can see this in my previous trip report. When you enter the station, you have to go through security and you have to put your luggage in an X-ray scanner. Well, this is pretty much everywhere in China. Even if you take the metro, you have to put your luggage in an X-ray scanner. This high-speed railway station is perfectly within reach of the metro, which has just been opened 2 months before I shot this video. Chinese high-speed railway stations are totally different from conventional railway stations. These stations are way bigger and they're ready for the future. At the time of the Beijing Olympics, the Chinese high-speed railway system had two lines. One line from Beijing to the coastal town of Shenzhen, which is a traditional high-speed line, and a maglev high-speed line from Shanghai to the airport. Within 10 years' time, it has extended to a network that's more than 29,000 kilometers long. Of all the high-speed lines you have in the world, about 50% of them is in China. And a high-speed line is a line where trains can go at least 200 kilometers per hour. During this trip from the Netherlands to China, I went to 5 different high-speed railway stations in China. From my experience point of view, the layout of most of the stations is pretty much the same. At the lower level, you will find the arrivals, and there's a higher level where you can find the departures. When you have to change trains, you can use the transfer channel, so from the arrival area to the departure area. In the departure hall, you'll find lots of shops, convenience stores, fast food restaurants, etc. There's also a special waiting area, and I think this was for the business class passengers. In the middle of the station, you will find an information point. Information in English is okay, but there's still some improvements to make. Just to make sure you won't miss your train, check your train tickets, departure time, and platform before you do anything else, so you know where you have to go for your train. Before you enter the platform, your tickets will be checked, so you don't have to worry, you'll be at the wrong platform. Elderly people and people who are traveling with young children may enter the platform first. You can use both the gates to enter the platform, or someone can check it by hand. Today I'll be traveling on a CR8-380AL train. The designed top speed for regular service is 380 km per hour and is a maximum seating capacity of 1027 people.
Start it up!
As the train sets off from Lanzhou via Xi'an to Beijing, the conductor will hand out some goodies. And as long as they have Oreo cookies, I'm good. As I mentioned earlier in this video, today I'll be traveling first class. First class in both D and G trains comes in a 2x2 configuration. Just like the previous D train I had from Urumqi to Lanzhou, you have an awful lot of leg space. You'll find a fold-out table in the armrest, and the windowsill is also pretty wide, so this also serves like a table. The seats can be reclined a lot. And due to the huge amount of leg space, you won't bother the person who's behind you. Just like in many trains, you will find a sunscreen. All seats are facing forward. But when you're traveling with a group of four and you want to have seats that are facing each other, you can just turn some seats around. There is a lot of luggage space in the overhead racks, but also between the carriages you will find some extra luggage space, and because the seats are all facing forward, you will also find some extra space behind the last row. The first class seats do also have an entertainment system, although I didn't try it out. Between the chairs you will find a power plug. When first class is too humble for you, you can always travel in business class. This will not just give you more space and more relaxed seats, but also a lot more service. The prices for business class seats are way higher than first and especially second class seats, but because there are such a small number of these seats, they are pretty much always booked out. Only at the beginning of my journey they were all free, but well, this only lasted until the first station. You'll find both non-Western and Western style toilets. Just like in my previous trip report, the toilets, well, the train in general was kept pretty clean during the way. Apart from the sinks in the toilets to wash your hands, you will also find sinks at the balconies of the train. And throughout the train you will find lots of points to tap hot water for tea or noodles. Second class comes in a 2x3 configuration, and just like the first class, the seats are always facing forward, what means you have extra space for your luggage behind the last row. The overhead luggage racks are the same all over the train in second, first and business class. And of course, between the carriages you will find some extra space for your luggage here as well. On second class you will find the power plugs at the same spots as in the first class. You also have a fold-out table that's located in the chair in front of you, and also in the second class you have a lot of leg space. Of course, there's some place to hang your coat as well. At first I thought that the seats in the second class were a little bit narrow, but I came back from this point of view after I went on a flight from Shanghai to Busan. I just haven't been on an aeroplane for a long time. Because for both environmental reasons and because I like trains, I just try to take the train as much as possible. In this train you also find a dining car. Chinese high-speed trains and trolleys work perfectly together, which means that food is also being served at your seat. This counts for all classes. You can pay using cash, Alipay or WePay. The menu looks pretty big, but I can't help feeling if I would have enjoyed the menu more when I would speak Chinese. There are loads of screens with information, and at the end of each carriage you also find the LED screen with food information, both in Chinese and English. Seat numbers in China are pretty standardized. A is always window seat, B middle and C aisle. Well, the same thing counts for D, E and F. And when one of these chairs is not available, well, the ladder is just skipped. As I mentioned in the beginning of this video, some of the views along the way are pretty stunning. Apart from that, from the train you can see the huge both infrastructural and urban development of China, with, like what I mentioned earlier, huge railway stations. Here are some glimpses of what you may expect when you're traveling from Lanzhou via Xi'an to Beijing. The train makes some stops, well, that would take maximum 4 minutes, where lots of people just go out and smoke cigarettes. The more the train travels eastwards, the denser it gets. When it's almost dark, the train is arriving in Beijing. When you saw some previous trip reports of mine, or when you maybe subscribe to my channel, you know how I end up all my trip reports. I point a camera in my face and well, just say my thing and share what I just experienced. I forgot to do this in Beijing, so I just took the camera in the city for one day and just, well, filmed the tourist event. So I have at least some time to, well, just say something. Although normally I make videos about trains, and I do photography, well, for the other stuff. As always, I hope you like this trip report. Please give me a thumbs up, like my video, and when you like to see more trip reports by train, just subscribe to my channel. See you on my next trip report that will be from Beijing to Shanghai on another G train in second class.